Question number 41. Which feature of Azure Active Directory will require users to have their mobile phone in order to be able to log in? Option A, Azure Information Protection. Option B, Advanced Threat Protection. Option C, Microsoft Defender for Cloud. Option D, Multi-Factor Authentication. The correct answer is Option D, Multi-Factor Authentication. Azure AD Multi-Factor Authentication adds an extra layer of security to user logins by requiring two or more verification methods, such as a password and a mobile phone, via SMS, phone call, or authenticator app. This helps protect account from unauthorized access, even if the password is compromised. Question number 42. Who is responsible for the security of your Azure Storage account access keys? Option A, Azure is responsible for securing the access keys. Option B, I am responsible for securing the access keys. The correct answer is Option B, I am responsible for securing the access keys. While Azure provides security features to help protect your storage account access keys, it is ultimately your responsibility to manage and secure them. You should rotate access keys regularly, store them securely using Azure Key Vault or another secure method, limit access to keys by using role-based access control, and shared access signature where possible. Question number 43. Which of the following is something that Azure Cognitive Services API can currently do? Option A, translate text from one language to another. Option B, recognize text in an image. Option C, create text from audio. Option D, speak text in an extremely realistic way. Option E, all of these. Azure can do it all. The correct answer is Option E, all of these. Azure can do it all. Azure Cognitive Services provide a wide range of AI-powered APIs that can perform various tasks, including translate text. Azure Translator API can convert text from one language to another, recognize text in an image. Computer Vision API can perform OCR, optical character recognition, create text from audio. Speech-to-text API converts spoken word into written text. Speak text in a realistic way. Text-to-speech API generates lifelike speech using neural voices. Question number 44. Can you give someone else access to your Azure subscription without giving them your username and password? Option A, yes. Option B, no. The correct answer is Option A, yes. You can grant access to your Azure subscription without sharing your username and password by using Azure Role-Based Access Control, RBAC. RBAC allows you to assign specific roles such as reader, contributor, or owner to users, groups, or service principals, giving them the appropriate level of access to your resources without exposing your credentials. This ensures security, control, and proper access management in your Azure environment. Question number 45. If you wanted to simply use Azure as an extension of your own data center, not primarily hosting anything there, but using it for extra storage or taking advantage of some services, what hosting model is that called? Option A, private cloud. Option B, hybrid cloud. Option C, public cloud. The correct answer is option B, hybrid cloud. A hybrid cloud model allows you to extend your on-premises data center to Azure, using it for extra storage, backup, disaster recovery, or additional computing power while still keeping primary workload on your own infrastructure. Just a quick reminder, if you don't want to watch all these videos and instead download all questions and answers, then feel free to purchase them on Buy Me a Coffee page. I have shared the link below. Question number 46. What feature within Azure will make recommendation to you about reducing cost on your account? Option A, Azure Dashboard. Option B, Azure Service Health. Option C, Azure Advisor. Option D, Microsoft Defender for Cloud. The correct answer is option C, Azure Advisor. Azure Advisor provides recommendation to optimize cost, performance, security, and availability in your Azure account. It helps you reduce expenses by suggesting ways to resize or shut down unused resources. Question number 47. In Microsoft Azure, which tool or service allows for the organization and management of multiple subscriptions within hierarchical structures? Option A, RBAC, Role-Based Access Control. Option B, Resource Groups. Option C, Management Groups. Option D, Azure Active Directory. The correct answer is option C, Management Groups. Azure Management Groups helps organize and manage multiple subscriptions in a hierarchical structure. They allow you to apply policies, access controls, and compliance rules across all subscriptions within the group. Question number 48. Which of the following characteristics of a cloud-based system primarily contributes to its elasticity? Option A, the system's ability to withstand denial of service attacks. Option B, the system's ability to dynamically increase and decrease capacity based on real-time demand. Option C, the system's ability to maintain availability while updates are being implemented. Option D, the system's ability to recover automatically after a crash. The correct answer is option B, the system's ability to dynamically increase and decrease capacity based on real-time demand. Elasticity in cloud computing refers to the system's ability to automatically scale resources up or down based on demand. This ensures cost efficiency and performance optimization. Question number 49. An IT administrator has the requirement to control access to to a specific app resource using multi-factor authentication. What Azure service satisfies this requirement? Option A, Microsoft Intra ID. Option B, Azure Authorization. Option C, Azure Function. Option D, Azure Authentication. The correct answer is Option A, Microsoft Intra ID. Microsoft Intra ID, formerly Azure Active Directory, provides multi-factor authentication, MFA, to enhance security by requiring users to verify their identity using a second factor, example, phone, SMS, or authentication app, before accessing resources. Question number 50. Which of the following Azure features is most likely to deliver the most immediate savings when it comes to reducing Azure cost? Option A, changing your storage account from globally redundant to locally redundant. Option B, using Azure policy to restrict the user of expensive VM SKUs. Option C, auto shutdown of development and QA servers overnight and on weekends. Option D, using Azure Reserved instances for most of your virtual machines. The correct answer is Option C, auto shutdown of development and QA servers overnight and on weekends. Automatically shutting down development and QA servers during non-business hours, example, overnight and weekends, offer immediate saving by preventing unnecessary cost when these resources are not being actively used. This strategy is quick to implement and can significantly reduce compute charges without impacting critical systems.